Hello, my friends. Today we're talking about a storage plan. I haven't addressed that this year, and I thought that I should. So you'll need some paper and something to write with, hopefully with an eraser, like a friction pen or a pencil. And you're going to make a list of each room in your house, or a list for each room of your house, so a page for each room. And on that page, you're going to write what's supposed to be in each of the cabinets, on each of the shelves, in each of the cupboards, under the bed, whatever it is that you're planning on storing things in your precious storage space. So take that piece of paper and go into your living room and look around at all the different places you have to store. This is especially fresh in my head because I've just moved into an RV and I have to put things in the storage spaces. So in my living room, I have cabinetry above the kitchen table. I have pull-out drawers under the seats. I have cabinetry across the top of the couch and above my head here. So I need to know what goes in those things. So I'll give you my example. Cookbooks and other books go right up here. Over here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 cabinets. That's got groceries in it. It's got my dry goods in there, even though it's the living room. In the cabinets above the table, I have, Mr. B has a cabinet, and I have some things like blender, the toaster, the crock pot, things like that are up there. Under the two pullouts, Mr. B keeps his business things and the drawer under his seat, and the drawer under my seat is right now towels, extra towels. So that's where they go in this house. Now, I think that sounds crazy for a home, but it's great for this home. It works for us. So it doesn't matter what's in your storage as long as you know where it goes, and that's what happens. Now let's go into the kitchen. So in this house, let me turn this way. Now I'm looking at the kitchen. So I have cabinets above the sink. I have pots and pans, dishes, and cups in that cabinet. Underneath the sink, I have a garbage can, and I have some cleaning products. To the side of that, I have three drawers. One is my silverware drawer. One is my like spoons and can opener kind of drawer. And then in the bottom drawer, things that are less used, plus my measuring tools are in that one. Then there's a stove in the middle. On the three drawers to the right of the stove, the top drawer has my dishcloths and dish towels in it. The next one has my spices in it. And the bottom one is a really little drawer, and I just keep extra cleaning supplies in there. So at this time, I've got a little thing of garbage bags, and I have a little set of scrubbers that I'm not using right now. That goes in there. Above that set of drawers, which is to the right of the microwave and over the coffee maker, is supplies for making coffee and tea and hot cocoa. That goes in there. To the right of that is the refrigerator. To the right of that is a slide-out pantry, and all my canned goods are in there. And the bottom slide-out pantry has overflow canned goods and baggies and aluminum foil and glad wrap and things like that. That's what's in the bottom. Across from that, there are two flat surfaces that have storage right across from that, and that's more on the inside, so I can put things that aren't going to get warmer, because these outside walls sometimes can get a little warm when it's 100 degrees outside. So my Dove chocolates are on the inside. My coffee is on the inside. Some medicines are on the inside. That's what's on that side. Okay, so there's an example for you of where you're going to put things. What are you going to do with things? Now, I do have in this living room additional cabinetry above the bridge or the cockpit where you drive. And in the one right over my seat is all of my plasticware. My bowls, my drainer, all that is, my salad spinner, all that is above my seat. And then across the front, I can't even remember what's in there because I've just started putting it in there, but I believe Oh yeah, my other Tupperware is over there. And I think that's it for now. That's all I have. So you have to have a place for things. So this is kind of a morphed space, you know, a living room, kitchen, dining room combination. So you have separate rooms for yours. So you're going to say, this is where my silverware goes. If you have a junk drawer, this is where my junk drawer goes. I can't have a junk drawer in here. So I have to have a specific place where I keep scissors, tape, pens, etc. But you might have a drawer that you call a junk drawer in your kitchen. So I hope you get the idea that there needs to be a place for everything. In my bedroom, I have a drawer for pajamas, and I have a drawer for underwear and socks and bras and things, well, underwear and socks. So that's a drawer. Mr. B has a couple of drawers for his stuff. And then there's cabinets in there for, I have baskets inside the cabinets in there that have all of our medical equipment. You know, not that we have medical equipment, our first aid, band-aids and alcohol and antacids and things like that are in one of those baskets. So, and in the closet, all of our clothes are hanging and our shoes are on the floor. And under the bed, there's also storage because the bed lifts up. I have extra towels there, extra sheets and a quilt under there, and a little bit of winter clothing under there. So that's where that goes. So you have to think about where you're going to put things and how much room you have, and know that every piece of space you have is dear. So it has to be something you really love, really need, and really use, and or really use. Okay? So that's what you're going to do. You're going to design each room and say, this is where, we don't have games here, so I don't have to worry about games. But if you did have games, this is where the games go. This is where the exercise equipment goes. This is where the children's outside toys go. This is where the shoes that the kids bring into the house go. This is where, you know what I mean by that? Some of you might have a basket or something for the shoes to go in when you come in the house. This is where coats go. This is where the dog's leash hangs. This is where the keys go. This is where my purse lives. Everything has to be in its place, or you're going to hunt all over for your purse one day. Okay? So find a place for everything in your home. That's very, very important. Write it down so that if you ever have a question, you can look and say, oh yeah, that's where I'm supposed to put that. And you have that plan. You also want to have a plan for each room for cleaning, but we'll talk about that later. For now, I want you to have a plan for each room for storage. I hope you think about this. I hope you start working on this, because this is going to help you as you declutter, knowing where things go. Nothing will be in concrete, which is why I said write it in Frixion pen, which is erasable. Here's a Frixion pen. It's actually pronounced friction. It's Frixion, but I've always called it Frixion. I don't know why, and now I'm stuck with that, but it's a friction pen. It's erasable. So if you write in a friction pen, that'll work, or you can use a pencil. Whatever works for you. Okay, that's it for today. I hope this was helpful, and I hope you always remember to be beautiful, because you are beautiful.